Dear friends, in this video, we are about to see some basics of Visual Basic.NET IDE, that is Visual Studio. Here we are, we have a new project and by default that this will be the layout. If any of these sub windows are not visible or the layout is not proper, you can just go to view menu and you can choose from different windows. Or if you want the default user interface, interface of IDE, you can just go to window menu and you can give reset window layout and you will get the default layout. This is a work area. Here you may have multiple files open. You can choose among them and you can work. If you have lots of files, you can see the arrow in the corner. And the next thing that you may notice is Solution Explorer, which is just adjacent to that, and it is in the right hand side top corner, Solution Explorer. All the files of your project will be visible here, and you have by default your form will be selected for a GUI application. For that form you have option View Code and View Designer. There are two options, just the last two options. And if you want to know the properties, you can just click properties. Some of the properties will be opened in this properties window, except this few special ones such as solution properties. If you right click, if you click on the solution and if you right click on the properties, you will get a exclusive solution properties. Here you can set assembly name. And if you want to choose some debug options, just command line arguments you can give, or compile operations if you want, you can change. There are many more you can see among here. And if you don't want this, you can just close it. If you want to view all the files which are part of your solution, you can just click Show All Files. Show All Files will give a exhaustive list of different files involved in your project. You can see there are plenty of things behind the scene. Visual Basic.NET IDE, Visual Studio will manage all these things for you. These are the directories which are created for your solution. If you build, they will be populated. If you want to refresh to see if there are more files or less files, you can click refresh. As part of the Solution Explorer, you have seen different things. And if you don't want all these files, you can just click it once again, Show All Files, to get into normal mode. Now, let us get into this form. This form, if you just run, that is a blank window. If you want to do some changes, you can drag and drop some user interface elements from the toolbox. Toolbox is another window. Where you have lots of controls, containers, dialog boxes, and many more. You can see there are plenty of things here. You can have even reports, some of them which are optional components. You can get them installed and you can get them here. Now, for simplicity, for the demonstration sake, let us add few components such as one button here and one text box. Maybe one label. You can play with all these things. Now if you want to change some of the attributes of these items, they are called properties. You choose one. I have chosen label. I want to change its text. Here you are. I will write name like this. And there are plenty of properties for each individual item, including its size attributes. There are many things which are available in properties window. If you just click on some user interface item, you will get the hierarchy from where you are getting this user interface elements. It is from systems, windows, forms, label. If you click on text box, that can be different. If you click on the button, you will get about details about button. Now for the button, there are plenty of properties. By default, the properties are available in alphabetical order. You can also choose categorical order, categories according to different use cases, such as design elements, data elements, appearance, accessibility. There are many more options. I will choose alphabetical order. We'll change button name to say hello. You can change button's variable name also, that is available as a name. Then you have plenty of options such as to change background color, to change size, to change foreground color, to change font, to put some image, set the transparency. There are many things. So now I'll click on the window. I want to change this window title to welcome. One very important option is enabled. Now let us get into this text of the form. Let's make it welcome. Now you can see there are plenty of events also. Click events, you will get them. If now I have selected window, and hence you are getting window events, form and the form events. Form events such as resize, paint, mouse down up and key down, key up. There are form closing, form closed, the many events. All the events are listed here. And I want to handle the event of this button. I will click the button, and there is a click event. I want to deal with this event. And so I will just double click it, and that will be added to my form. There on my form now. You will get the help of auto completion or the IntelliSense. You just type a key, you get different options available. I want to display a message. I will just type MSG message box. This is a suggestion I have got, and you can see what are the different arguments which are required for this message box function. Type it once again, message box. So the first option is prompt, and the second option is about button, third option is about title, so on. So I will just write a simple message. Hello. Let us run this debug. The window with the title welcome. I click on say hello. Hello, this will be dialog. So let us close this. Now, if I want some text which was there in this text box along with hello. So for that, what is the name of this text box? Click on that and you will get the name text box one. So to access its text, what is the property? You can just go to the properties, and there you have text. If you type something here, that will appear here, and that is why I'll just remove this. And we'll go to code. There, instead of just hello, let me get that text. We'll use a variable. If you want to know what is the data type of those things, you can use these properties and its data type, or you can use Object Explorer, that we will see soon. Now let me create a string variable, name s as string. Of yes, I will use name as string, and name is equal to text box one, is the name of the text box one dot text. So the text is stored into the name, and now I will include that name here so that I can use ampersand as concatenation operator name. Just leave one space here. Now if we run, say hello, just hello, you enter your name, that will be your name. So here we are, and there can be some problems while doing your program. For instance, you get some logical error, then you can use breakpoints, which are very helpful. You just click on this margin, drop a breakpoint, which is a red color bindi as of here. And now if you debug, when this when I will put some text here, I will click this button. Now the breakpoint will be executed, and in the breakpoint system will wait for your input to continue or to do something else. During execution, automatically you will also get the immediate window. There, if you want to examine different variables, you can examine. For instance, I want to see what is the value in name. For that, I will put a question mark and I will type name. See, the value of the variable name is u. And you can type any expression. For example, to evaluate 1 plus 2, you can type question mark 1 plus 2 will be evaluated. This is quite handy, immediate window. If you just want to check the values, you can also use your mouse cursor. If you place your mouse cursor on a variable name, you will get that variable name along with its value. And if you place that cursor on some other object, such as text box, you will get a complete list of its properties. As you can see here, there are plenty of properties, and along with its values, each individual property will have some value. Let's see that again. Here down there somewhere else, somewhere you have that text property. There are plenty of properties. Here we are, text is u, right? So these kind of things will help us to a great extent to solve our issues if there are any unexpected results. Now to resume the operation, you can just click on this continue, or you can use shortcut key F5, or you can step into or step over or step out. You can use these different options too. For now, let us continue. We have got our messages. Okay, let's stop. If you want to remove this breakpoint, you just click on the bindi. It will be gone. Object browser is very handy to know about particular object and its particulars. In my interface, the object browser is not visible as of now. For that, I should use the shortcut key F2. I will just press F2. If you press F2, you will get object browser window. There you get all components and the possible things. I will just search for text box, and here we go. There are many options. We have used system windows forms text box. I'll choose that. You'll get all the properties, events, and if you choose something, for example, I will choose text property now. What is that? Here, text, you will get its type. This is how I got to know about that data type as string. It's data type. If you have a method, you have its arguments. So, example, click on some random method. Here, its argument details are also available, and also some summary for the argument or the parameter descriptions. All these things are available in the object browser. So this object browser is very handy. Use it frequently. Let me close this object explorer as of now. Let me make a small mistake. Instead of text box 1, I will make it as text box 11. Now let us see what happens if I try to run. Before running itself, we will get a underline and a red exclamation, which is also available in error list. Error list window will help you to solve your syntactical errors. So for instance, this is a, see here, text box 11 is not declared. It may be inaccessible due to its protection level. See, text box 1 is not declared. This is very clear. I know that it is not declared. That means I have mistyped its spelling. I'll just change it like this. We can repair ourselves. You can also use output window. In my interface, output window is not visible. I should use shortcut key Control Alt O. Output window will be visible. See, here you can see different status messages. If you wish, you can have this output window. So this is about some basics of Visual Basic .NET IDE, that is Visual Studio. It's a basic user interface. You can look into different menus and you can use helps to see more things. You can go to different links here, and MSDN is very helpful if you want to get details about all these things. Thank you for watching. Take care.